Hey everyone, Synology have been really busy. They've been busy killing off H.264 transcoding support. They've been busy launching new NASes with underpowered hardware, yet again, and they've been very busy killing off third-party hard drive support and then changing their mind again. It's all been a complete mess, to be honest, which is why I'm really glad that this is here. This is the LinkStation N2. I've used it for a few weeks now and it packs a real punch. It's really small, so it can fit in a backpack when you're traveling, but it's also got loads of power, including four NVMe drives and a 10 gig Ethernet port. This makes this NAS really useful if you want quick access to your files, but who exactly are LinkStation and why should you buy something like the N2 instead of a UGREEN product? Well, I think I've actually worked out the answer to that question because this product is actually really competitively priced compared to things like UGREEN and Synology. I'm going to talk about that a bit later, but first, what is the LinkStation N2? Well, as I've already mentioned, it's got space for four NVMe drives, meaning you can access your files really, really quickly, but if you also had much bigger files you wanted to store and archive away, it's got space for two hard drives or SATA SSDs via the drive bays in the front here. Now, it is only 2.5 inch as opposed to 3.5 inch support, but to be honest, you know, for something like this, this is designed for quick access to files. If you wanted to store, like, you know, 200 terabytes of data, then you're probably going to want to build your own NAS and actually load it up with a 3.5 inch hard drives. But if you simply wanted, you know, quite a lot of storage space in a very small footprint, then something like this is completely perfect. It's also got a really good CPU, a 4-core Alder Lake N100 CPU, which means it's really good for like Plex streaming and things like that. This LinkStation NAS also comes with 16 gig of RAM, which is really, really good, especially compared to some of the UGREEN offerings. And to be honest, because this supports Unraid, which I'll talk about in just a second, that 16 gig can be really useful because it means you can load this up with like Docker containers and things like that, and that can be quite RAM heavy, and as a result, having 16 gigs in here is really good. And then we come to the actual back I/O. It's got a 10 gig Ethernet jack, it's got a USB 3.2 port along with two 2.0 ones as well, just in case you needed that. It's also got a HDMI port and an audio port, so if you wanted to use this as like a media TV, you could do that. It's also got space in the front for a USB-C port, which is 10 gigabits, making it ideal for actually moving large files quickly onto your NAS. And in general, you know, the hardware and the connectivity is much better on this than something like Synology and also UGREEN, in my opinion, and I'll talk about that more in a minute. But next, I wanted to talk about Unraid, because this comes preloaded with Unraid, or you could actually install TrueNAS on here. So basically, if you didn't want to build your own NAS, you could just buy something like this and, you know, get something that's super small. Like, you're probably not going to be able to build a NAS that's as small as this. You're going to get something that's super small for a fairly competitive price. Next, I wanted to talk about the actual design and features and everything else, because yeah, I'll show the measurements on the screen now, but it's absolutely tiny. You could easily, you know, move this around. It weighs less than a kilogram as well. You could put it in your backpack when traveling, and let's say you're a content creator, you could very easily store all your media on here and basically get a really, really good quality, you know, mobile editing solution. Now, I have been using this for a few weeks, and before I talk about my hands-on experience with this particular product, I quickly wanted to talk about one or two other aspects of it. And the first is going to be the thermals, because obviously the NVMe drives do give off a lot of heat. And what you'll notice on the back, which is where you store your NVMe drives, this simply pops out and you can put one, two NVMe drives in there. And then in the other side, you can put another two. And there's only one in here right now. I'll talk about that later on in the video. But essentially, this is where you put the four NVMe drives if you wanted four of them. It's a toolless install, so you just pop that up and it's really easy to put the NVMe drives in and out. And then when you're done, you just put the door back on. So it's actually really, really convenient. Same as the drive bays at the front, they just pop in and out and it's really, really easy. In terms of how this is cooled, in addition to the thermal pad, there is an actual fan in here, and I'll talk about that later on in the video because LinkStation say it should be silent, but I actually found it a little bit noisy. But essentially, in the actual storage compartments of the NVMe's, you've got different fan grills running all along here, you've got a fan vent here, and then at the back as well, you've got actual fan vent there. So what that actually means is constantly the heat from the NVMe drives is being cooled by the pad, then all the heat, all the excess heat is actually coming out of the different fan vents, the hot air is being pushed out. So actually it's quite a good design, and the power consumption is very impressive as well. By default, when I turned it on, it was using like 5 or 6 watts, and then when I was using it with admittedly just one NVMe drive in there and I was moving files back and forth, the power usage went up to 10 to 15 watts, but that is still very, very good. Now, this does have a fan on it, like I've already touched on, and on the website, LinkStation say that this is completely quiet, but to be honest, that wasn't completely my experience either, because the actual fan inside here was constantly whirring, even with just one NVMe drive in here. I'll put an example in just a minute, but I did find the fan to be a little bit noisier than some of the other NASes I've used. But overall, I am nitpicking a little bit because that fan noise isn't substantial, and, you know, to actually have four NVMe drives and space for two other hard drives or SATA SSDs too means that this device could get fairly hot. So the fact it's got an active fan in there is a good thing, not a bad thing. But just wanted to be completely honest about, you know, the downsides of this NAS, because in general, this is a very, very good NAS, but obviously nothing is perfect. So I just wanted to mention some of those flaws. But in general, again, this setup is really easy. The way you put the NVMe drives in is completely toolless, as you can see on the screen now. So you put your NVMe drives in there, and obviously the SATA SSDs or hard drives as well in the front. Then you put the power cord in and you turn the device on. And this, as I mentioned, is preloaded with Unraid 6.9, which came out in January 2025. And what's nice about this is it comes with an Unraid starter license, which supports up to six different devices. But you've also got an Unraid trial as well for 30 days. So, you know, you could always start off with the Unraid trial. And if you don't like it for some reason, you can move back to True NAS or something like that. And one of the big things that interested me in this is it's got a 10 gig Ethernet port, which is something that Synology still doesn't do, even in 2025, on some of their higher end models. You need to resort to adapters and PCI Express cards, which completely sucks. I don't know why Synology do that, but LinkStation have actually, you know, applied common sense. And this is an NVMe NAS in general, so, you know, having a 10 gig uplink means you can use a lot of the power of those NVMe drives. So that is completely brilliant. And I did actually test this with a 10 gig network switch, and I'd done all my video editing for multiple weeks over the network. Work, and it worked completely flawlessly. So overall, I'm very impressed with this, but after using it for a few weeks, and I wanted to dive into my sort of real world thoughts of this. So firstly, what I really liked about this is it looks really good. It runs fairly cool. The power consumption is low, and it's also just really light, and it's also really small. Like if you were going to build your own mini ITX NAS, it's going to end up bigger than this. I also really liked how powerful the hardware is in this. I mean, it's got 16 gigs of RAM. It's got 4-core 12th gen Intel CPU, meaning that this is perfect for running, you know, Docker containers and VMs and Plex streaming and all of those things you might want to do. I think this is priced fairly competitively as well. Like I'll show the prices on the screen now. And what you notice is UGREEN actually have a couple of NASes. I think the DXP 2800 and the DXP 4800. And I feel that this is priced kind of in the middle of both of them. But what's interesting is even the DXP 4800, that only supports two NVMe drives, but this one obviously has four NVMe drive supports. And yes, it only supports two 2.5-inch drives, whereas the UGREEN one I mentioned actually supports four 3.5-inch drives. But actually, you know, if you did want the fastest possible connection speeds from your NAS, then this would work really well, whereas some of the other UGREEN ones that I just mentioned aren't going to work out as well. So I think this is a big win for this. And that brings me onto the downsides of this. And the main issue I noticed really is the fan noise. Like I'm quite sensitive to having, you know, unnecessary noise. And, you know, with this, sometimes I just had like one NVMe drive in just to test things out. It was running at like 30 degrees Celsius, which is very, very cool. And yet the fan was actually running quite a lot. It was making a decent amount of noise. Equally, the fact this supports 2.5-inch drives is arguably a positive because it means that the form factor can be smaller, but it does mean that, you know, if you really are into NASes, you're probably going to have loads of 3.5-inch drives lying around. Certainly I know I do, and obviously you can't then use this particular NAS with that. And my final issue might not actually be an issue with this, and I'll probably put a pinned comment or something in the description when I know more and I've tested things out more, but basically you will have noticed I've been running with just one NVMe drive in here. And what I noticed is that my second NVMe drive, which is healthy according to like Crystal Disk Info and Crystal Disk Spark and everything else, for some reason this particular drive often isn't being detected in here. Like what I notice is, you know, I'll have it installed in one of the ports as normal, and I'll open up Unraid and suddenly it'll say that the drive is missing, and it's not clear why, because obviously it's just there completely normally. And what I've sometimes got to do is like reformat this drive or move it to a different port for it to then be detected. And yeah, it's a really, really weird issue. What I'm going to be doing now after this video is putting this in my HomeLab NAS, which also runs Unraid, and I'm going to see what happens there. And then I'll put more details in the description or a pinned comment to actually say what my results were. But in general, I am very, very impressed with this. I know I've spoken about some of the flaws of it, but you know, I wouldn't be doing my job as a content creator if I didn't actually talk about some of the issues with this NAS. I wanted to be completely honest with all of you. But just simply having, you know, 10 gig and lots of NVMe drives means that this is far ahead of like what Synology and UGREEN are offering. So overall, I would definitely recommend this NAS. If you've got any questions, please leave them in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button, and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.